your second album, Rounder Record. But so this album was no distribution, no original songs on it, but the album went gold. Correct. Can you tell me a little bit about that?
I sure can. Our first album came out and we created a stir with the first one. And it was doing well. And the president of the label said, if we could, it's a matter of what, if George wants a gold record, that we can pick up major distribution, like hire Universal or something like that to distribute. And I said, if we're doing this good, independently, without anything else. So before I got the plan, everybody used to say this to me, and I mean everybody, you're never going to go anywhere without originals. You won't make it. My stance I took was, I'll bet I could put an album together with no originals on it. It could be a damn good record, and I'll bet we can sell even more. Let's do it on our own, and let's see what the majors have to say about that. Man, the president of the company, man, she lit up like a Christmas tree, because that's what Rounder's all about, the last of the independents. I said, so let's do that. Then we'll show them we can do it, as long as it's good material. Word of mouth will get out there, and it'll sell without the distribution. And it did. So we came back to us. It didn't shock us, because I'd be playing in clubs and I'd do Bourbon, Scotch and Beer, Madison Blues, things like that I didn't write. Nobody cared. Yeah. They dug the song. They go crazy over it. The average person, do you think they know who wrote A Boy Named Sue? Johnny Cash didn't write it. So nobody cares about that. They just dig the sound of it. So we were very meticulous in selecting this material on here. And said, I'm not ready to go with originals yet. And I have a project that I want to do. Step One was the first album. This was the ultimate success.
Yeah. Thank you very much. Put that right up there, right between Bo Diddley and John Lee Hooker.